My name is Achim Laumstein. I'm an ABB employee from Germany. I'm working in ABB for control systems and in R&D. But today I'm representing the Fieldcom Group. In this function as the Fieldcom Group Technology Director, I'd like to introduce to you FDI and how FDI uses OPC UA and how this helps to integrate field devices from a process automation point of view into Industry 4.0 architectures. So let me first briefly describe what Fieldcom Group is. Maybe some of you know Fieldcom Group, and some of your companies are probably member of the Fieldcom Group. So the Fieldcom Group is dealing with digital communication and integration technologies for process automation, that's their focus. And here you see the member companies is more than 340 members. And the major technologies that Fieldcom Group is hosting is the HART communication protocols, Foundation Feedbus, and FDI. And FDI shall be now the focus of this presentation. FDI means field device integration, but the FDI architecture provides much more than field device integration, and this is what I'd like to show today here. So FDI covers all those different kind of communication protocols that are used in process automation. So the different variants of HART, FSK, HART IP, Wireless HART, Foundation Feedbus, Profibus, Profinet, Modbus, and also ISA 100, which is another wireless protocol. And FDI, on one hand, helps to integrate those field devices into automation systems and allows to configure, maintain those field devices in a standardized way, but it also enables to provide data from those devices to higher level applications symbolized by the cloud here. And I think this is the very important thing here. It enables to provide data from those kind of devices, from the various field buses here to the cloud, from existing field buses to the cloud. And FDI, by this, supports also the Industry 4.0 architecture, and it is named in the reference architecture for the functional layer and for the information layer. And we have heard already a couple of times today that OPC UA is also part of this reference architecture, and therefore the combination of FDI plus OPC UA fits very well to integrate field devices into the Industry 4.0 world. So let's come back to the original motivation why FDI has been developed some years ago, and it's in the meantime, I think, nearly 10 years ago when it was started. So at that time we had two integration technologies, FDT and EDDL. FDT was and it still is based on Microsoft technologies, and EDDL is a description language, this ASCII text that is used to describe device functionality and user interfaces. And those were two competing technologies in the market, and this competing technologies caused, of course, effort and cost for device vendors, and also end users were not very happy with those competing technologies. So the compromise was to form and develop FDI, which is based on EDDL and takes features from FDT. And the good thing at that time was already, as I said, 10 years ago, the architects of FDI included OPC UA into that architecture. And maybe they did not know what the result would be now in these times of industry 4.0 architectures, but it perfectly fits. That's the result in the meantime. So we cover with FDI two major things: reduce lifecycle costs for device vendors and end users, for process automation devices. The goal here is to have one device package, and I explain what a device package is later, for all tools. The second thing is that with OPC UA, FDI enables open architectures. And here I mentioned NOAA. NOAA is NAMO Open Architecture. NAMO is a big organization, also mainly in Germany, of chemical, pharmaceutical, and oil and gas companies, and they standardize on requirements for process automation. And those NAMO guys have developed recently the NAMO Open Architecture. And Industry 4.0 is also a kind of application. It's also an open architecture where FDI fits. The third thing, which is covered by FDI, is up-to-date cybersecurity features. This means, in this specific case of device packages, signing of the packages, so the it is always known if the package is from the original manufacturer, and sandboxing ensures that the system environment cannot be disturbed by any kind of software application that is provided by an FDI package. So let's go into a little more details. So this is the overall picture of FDI. So these kind of devices are used in process industries. It's, for example, pressure transmitters, level transmitters, flow transmitters, positioners for electro-pneumatic valves, but it's also drives and motors that are used, and so there's a kind of overlap between machine automation, factory automation, with these devices here, while the others are mainly used in process automation. So such devices are virtualized in software, and this piece of software is called device package, FDI device package. The FDI device package is imported into an FDI server. And here you find again OPC UA. OPC UA is the interface between FDI servers and FDI clients. And by this architecture, you can implement very big systems with many clients, but you can also have client and server on one computer, so you can have a standalone tool. And we have heard this also in this morning already a couple of times. With OPC UA, data can also be provided to the cloud, so enabling once again those open architectures. And what you see here, there are two different kinds of clients for FDI. FDI clients, and this is not an FDI client, this is a generic OPC UA client. Both different kind of clients can access the information model that is provided here on the OPC UA server. So the objective of FDI, to summarize this again, is to simplify software installation, configuration, maintenance of field instruments. This is the first part, which would save costs for the device vendor, save costs for the end user, because there is only one integration technology. And the second part is provide data through OPC UA. Let's come back to this first part, simplification of device integration. Historically, there have been two major technologies, but there are also many other files involved to describe a device. There are user manuals, certificates, and such things. And so those files could have been very many for a single device, and it was always an issue to integrate a specific device into a specific system, and specific files had been required for specific systems. And this is supposed to be resolved by using FDI, one package for all tools per protocol. There is of course one package per protocol because the device models are different for the different protocols. So again, this is the device configuration, device management part of FDI that is covered by the FDI package. And the FDI package, in a little bit more detail, contains basically three things. The electronic device description, and the electronic device description describes all data a device has, the data description. It describes also user interfaces that are needed to configure a device. It has business logic to describe dependencies between different variables a device has, which shall be presented on the user interface level. This is the mandatory part of a device package, the EDD. Then there is an optional user interface plugin. This is a piece of software, and this is the part that comes from FDT. The user interface plugin is a .NET application or an HTML5 application. And this can be used optionally if the descriptive solution is not sufficient to present, for example, sophisticated graphics for a device. For example, for radio level transmitters, they need echo curves, and this is typically done by UIPs. And then there can be attachments. Attachments can be manuals, can be certificates, and for Fieldbus devices, Profibus or Foundation Fieldbus, also the protocol specific files are part of the attachments. For Profibus, for example, the GSD, or for Profinet, the GSD. For Foundation Fieldbus is a CFF file. So everything is bundled into one package for one device. And here's an example about UIP and UID. I said UID is also created through the electronic device description. So this is all described in ASCII text, and such user interfaces are then created through the interpreter of this description. And for more sophisticated user interfaces, the UIP, .NET or HTML5 based is used, and you can have some nicer graphics. But now back to the overall architecture and support of Industry 4.0, or for example, NAMOR open architecture. On the right side here, you see an FDI server. The FDI server imports an FDI device package, will be stored in a catalog of packages. The FDI server is connected to the various field buses through communication servers, and interestingly also those communication servers are interfacing to the FDI server through OPC UA. The FDI server has a business logic processor. This is an EDD interpreter. Said the EDD here, part of the package, will be executed in this EDD interpreter called Business Logic Processor. And the FDI server has an OPC UA information model. This information model includes all types of devices that are described or represented by those device packages, and it includes information on all instances, those devices that are really used in a specific plant. And the FDI server interfaces to FDI clients, and the FDI clients are those software components that provide human readable information through those user interfaces, descriptive user interfaces or programmed user interfaces, UID or UIP. This is the FDI client server system that is very well specified, and the FDI client accesses the information model, and by this gets all information that is needed to provide human readable information for those devices. And now the interesting thing is, with the OPC information model and OPC UA, we have the possibility to connect also generic OPC UA clients. And with these generic clients, we can provide information to any kind. Now, with this OPC interface, we can provide information to any kind of generic client, and also in machine readable form. And this is important for those Industry 4.0 applications. And I'd like to use now as an example the NAMUR open architecture, because as I said before, the NAMUR defines requirements for process industries towards automation vendors. And this is the NAMUR approach towards Industry 4.0, what you see here now, the first step. So in process industries, you have typically the automation pyramid. There are the devices, there's the communication and control layer, there's the HMI, the human-machine interface layer, and there are higher-level applications. And the NAMUR guys have said, now this pyramid is something we don't want to touch. Those are reliable systems. They are process control systems covering the whole stuff from I/O over controllers, HMI, and the systems are reliable. They work and they run over many years. This is also something maybe different to machine industry. They run those systems 20, 30 years, and they are not, they're quite conservative, they don't change so often. But they said they want to use the information that is available in those systems. Currently, it's more or less closed systems, and they say they want to get access to this information and use them on the cloud level. And they also said OPC UA shall be the interface. To get access to device information or information from the controller level, or higher levels in this automation pyramid. And this is where FDI fits in principle. You have seen the FDI architecture, feed level, server level, and OPC UA to provide information to clients. And in FDI, and I should say, and OPC, we have gone one step further now, because I mentioned machine-readable information. And for machine-readable information, you need some machine-readable semantics. And those semantic information has recently been added to the FDI, EDDL, and OPC UA specifications. And just to show you an example what that is. So let's assume we have an FDI server as a gateway to any kind of OPC UA client, could be cloud. So currently the FDI server has just provided information, and the client would have to be made aware of what this information is. So a specific software would have to be written to deal with this information. Now, the specifications have been enhanced in a way that semantic identifiers can be added to any kind of information. And the semantic identifiers are specified in IEC 61360, as for process automation specifically in IEC 61987. This is also called Common Data Dictionary. And now with these enhancements, the FDI information model through OPC UA provides semantic information to a FDI client, and the FDI client is aware of this semantic information and can use now the data without additional specific knowledge about the devices connected to this server. The semantic identifier looks, for example, like this here for a tag or for a unit. It's coded in such a way. This is all described in those IEC standards. And now part of the FDI, EDDL, and OPCUA specifications. So that can be implemented and used. And why are we doing this? And we go even one step further here now in standardizing information provided by field devices. So this is again an FDI server. The FDI server provides information through the information model. And the goal is that any kind of application can access the information in the FDI server and the information model. And there is different kind of information provided. A part of this information, device ID, for example, or device health, is already standardized in the OPCUA DI specification. Then we have process variables, specific services, parameters. These are not standardized across all those different devices from supporting different protocols. This is not yet available, but would be helpful if the information shall be used in a standardized way by applications up here. And then we have the part that is defined by FDI, user interfaces, business rules. This is a generic thing and described by the electronic device description. And so what I meant when I say we go a step further now, we define a process automation device information model, and this contains standard information that shall be the same for any kind of type of field device. So for any temperature transmitter, this information will be the same. For any flow transmitter, this information will be the same. And I think this is different from some other approaches that have been taken. In other approaches, protocol information is mapped onto device information models, and so you have still protocol-specific stuff up here. This is completely neutral. This is just following, again, NAMO requirements. They have said they want to have this kind of information standardized for their devices. They call it core parameters, and they have some other requirement specifications also for diagnosis. They have exactly said what they want to have for all devices. And FDI, and with this standardized approach of process automation device information model, FDI helps now to bring information from existing devices, for example, Profibus or HART, through mapping into this information model. This is something that can be done today, and the benefit here is existing systems, you have seen the pyramid, the process control systems can be enhanced with this solution because you can access the field buses and bypass the control systems with this solution. So by this you can bring information from existing field devices into the cloud. And we are discussing now another thing. This also has been part of what we have seen this morning here, OPCUA on field level. So the next step could be that such devices also communicate via OPCUA and embed the information model. And assuming we will have this, some people start to work on this already now. Assuming we have this, you will have complete transparency from the cloud level down to the field device, because the information model would be in the field device. And this would simplify a lot of things. You would not have to have specific mappings from a field bus through OPCUA to OPCUA information models. You could just aggregate the information models that are part of the device and provide information to the cloud in a yeah, protocol independent way, but OPC would then be the protocol. So, but in a kind of in a standardized way. And my assumption is this will be the next step. What I have shown before can be done today with FDI, mapping data from existing field devices, HART, Profibus, and so on, Profinet, to the OPC information model. And this might be something we will have in future. OPC on device level. This, also the next one, which is in principle the same. So we standardize already today the information that might be in future on the OPCUA field device. And we also have heard about Industry 4.0, Asset Administration Shell, and this is at least the first step, if not already the Asset Administration Shell for field devices. So we will take this PADIM, go with it to the Industry 4.0 consortium and say this is our proposal for the Asset Administration Shell. And now my summary. So what FDI in combination with OPCUA, and I think this is the important thing for today, while we are discussing open architecture. So with the FDI solution already today, information from existing field devices can be brought to the cloud level. And in addition to that, FDI resolves the issue of having different integration technologies. So one package for all tools is here the topic. And I think that's already it. Thank you for listening.